the presentation you did the other day, in the workshop, I think it was good. But can you tell me comments on that?
You mean the second day or on the first meeting?
First, the presentation you had prepared, with the PowerPoint and so on. You satisfied?
No.
Why not?
Yeah, well, I have prepared a PowerPoint presentation, but I have not verbally prepared what to talk about.
Okay. And that is a trap you very often fall into. Your presentation was good, but then learn from that, that next time you do a PowerPoint presentation, you also yourself, the PowerPoint is helps you, and it's that it's kind of reflects what you're saying when you do it well. It's not that you are dependent on what you have written on the PowerPoint.
It's so, not like, you know, well, in one PowerPoint I have a few points, but I don't like if you see that this point I can't remember all the text. But yes, in real is not.
But you didn't. You hadn't practiced enough then. Yeah. And try also that the PowerPoint is kind of illustrating what you're saying, rather than kind of leading you through what you're saying. And also try to have kind of notes, keynotes, and maybe in this case keynotes and the PowerPoint at the side, on the sheet of paper or on the screen. It's difficult because the screen is doing the projection, so you could have it printed on a paper. So you see the PowerPoint on your paper, you don't need to look at the television or board or whatever you have. And then you have points, keynotes, what you're going to say at the side. And then you follow the keynotes and not the PowerPoint. The PowerPoint is just that you should know what is shown behind you. And then you can turn towards the audience all the time. And when you switch, you can also see, then you can have the laptop in front of you. So you can see when you switch that you have the correct picture on the PowerPoint.
Yeah.
But this again is a kind of practice. Was it the first time you did this? PowerPoint presentation. Was it the first time you did a PowerPoint presentation? Yes. So I mean, it was very good, and then you can learn from this.
Yeah.
And do it so that also you are satisfied.
Yeah, and I feel like not bad at all.
You were not bad. You were good. But like you say, there are things, of course, that you can improve. And it's the risk about those PowerPoint presentations and so on, that you let them lead you. And that you start talking about the picture instead of about the topic.
I'm quite satisfied with the second presentation also on TOEFL.
Yes. That was good too. I think you, but that was just a situation. In that case, in your case, it was easier. Calden had his laptop down here, and since he had prepared to do it up there, it looked a bit odd when he had to look down all the time. But he just looked, and if he had had that as keynotes on a piece of paper, he would easily have been able to stand up and do his presentation. So if he had known he was to do it with a blackboard, he would easily have done it. And your presentation, you did it without blackboard and without PowerPoint. So, good presentation, I think.
Yes.
Okay, comments?
I feel like I have improved quite well in speaking.
You have.
And I'm told that it was due to, you know, working in a restaurant.
Could very well be that you're used to meeting people you don't know. And also your age has probably helped you. And many things are working in this direction for you.
But before the TOEFL test, I never did that, you know, to work in a restaurant for...
No?
I did like.
So that's probably has taught you a lot.
Yeah.
to be in that confrontation with foreign people. Okay? More comments?
Coming.